daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Just a little public service announcement. The ushers say things like rain, and someone has their car windows open in the parking lot. So if you have faith, you can stay. If you want to gamble, you might go and close your windows.
A reading from the Book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my fathers." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree. But then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. Elijah looked, and there at his head was a earth cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again, but the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him, and ordered, "Get up and eat, else the journey will be too long for you." He got up, ate and drank, then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. siete nombrata la persona dove c'è. Grazie. Mentre aspettare il suo rosario di cascina, tu non lo stai solo che c'è domani, la gente è più. Ieri, signore, spasso un vaso scelto a loro, un discendo, di niente, già scrivo, svivaggiando, grazie, scelto un sgoscio. Non c'è la scelta da fare il dono, non lo scelgo. Se facciai il sessualità, e anche il mio non si faccia un prestigio. Non c'è che non si faccia la stessa in dono, e anche c'è il secondo domani, in Costantino c'è il mio rosso. Poi questo si fa scrivere, e sapendo scegliere il giro, sarà offeso, e danno la morte di un uomo. Ora, sua voce.
Wszyscy oni umierali, ale do
spiaccini si accipati facili. Usate, tu ricordi provate, che con i santi trasercevi. Do, o sciamienci zero, miscionci cero, gemsi, orizonci, distanci, mani zieri. Con uomo, pan vuoti, lupe, nasco, scelto. Jednakże żaden z tych Bożych darów nie jest jeszcze pokarmem na życie wieczne. Na przestrzeni całej historii zbawienia Bóg gotował ludziom wiele niespodzianek. Czy jednak ktoś przypuszcza, że on sam jeszcze na siebie rolę Mesjasza i swojej miłości do człowieka, on sam stanie się jego pokarmem? Ja jestem chlebem żywym, który stąpił z nieba. Jeśli kto spożywa ten chleb, będzie żył na wieki. Chlebem, który jada, jest moje ciało za życie świata, mówi Chrystus. Ale co to oznacza? Już w ojcowie Kościoła zauważyli, że przyjmując normalne pożywienie śpiewanie, sprawia, że powoli przekształca się ona w nasze ciało. Staje się naszym ciałem. Gdy jednak przyjmujemy ciało Chrystusa, rzecz ma się odwrotne. To nie jest przekształcony się albo ulepnie wstąpianie się w ciało Chrystusa. Stajemy się do Niego podobne. Stajemy się bardziej Chrystusowi. W tym sensie przyjmowanie ciała Pańskiego, czyli nasz możliwy pełny udział w Eucharystii, najskuteczniej prowadzi nas w łatwą rzeczywistość Kościoła. Ten właśnie Kościół odsłania tam tajemnicę miłości Boga do człowieka i przedstawia nam Chrystusa jako wrót do naśladowania. Bądźcie naśladowcami Boga jako dzieci umiłowane i postępujcie drogą miłości, bo i Chrystus was umiłował i samego siebie wydał za nas papieża. Przypomina święty Paweł. Każdy, kto te słowo potraktował na serio i starał się je zrealizować w życiu, skraczał na drogę świętości. Dobytnie w słowie i w życiu wyraził to święty brat Albert. Patrzcie na Jezusa w Jego Eucharystii. Czy Jego miłość odniosła coś jeszcze piękniejszego? Skoro jest chlebem i miłość chlebem, skąd jestem, to nie jest jak on nadając się siebie sam. Nie wolno nam zapominać o wszechstronności Chrystusa. Jeżeli nie będziecie spożywać ciała Syna Człowieczego, nie będziecie piękniejsi, nie będziecie mieli życia w sobie. Chodzi tu oczywiście o nadprzyrodzony wymiar życia, o życie wieczne, łasce uświęcające. Doświadczenie religijne wiele chrześcijan potwierdza, że gdy przez dłuższy czas zaniedbujemy przystępowanie do komunii świętej, to życie Boże faktycznie w nas zamienia. Zaczyna się chrześcijański wegetacja. Niby żyjemy, ale życie to nie przynosi zbawienia owoców. Garni nas niechęcenie. Może więc i do nas zostało skierowanie do wezwania. Stań, jest, bo przed Tobą druga droga. Amen. We've entered a time in the church here that's rather interesting. First of all, because every year the Sundays are divided into different cycles, A, B, and C. And that means that we take the gospel accounts as it goes through Jesus' life and ministry from the three what they call synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke. This is year B, we hear from Matthew. Except last week we began an interruption. We're hearing from St. John, and we'll be hearing from St. John for a couple weeks. Because the church always inserts right around now into this cycle of agreements what we call the bread of life discourse. It is one of the few times also that we receive a sequential reading of the gospel people ask him, well, we want this bread all the time.
Who wouldn't?
Remember, he just sent the 5,000 of the loaves and fishes. So what were they looking for? Another for the belly? Or what Jesus truly had to offer? Well, he challenged them. He said, you have to do the work of the Father in order to get this type of reward, if you will. So they asked, well, what is the loaf? What is the work we have to do? Jesus answered something very interesting. He said, you must believe. What does that mean? That means in Jesus' mind, faith isn't just a static reality. Faith isn't a set of credo statements on the paper that you can profess and then go on with your regular life. Faith is work to Jesus. Because not only must we believe, but we must show that belief in how we live. Otherwise, there's another word for that. It's called hypocrite. Jesus didn't particularly like those kind of people. The ones who say one thing and do another. The ones who show one side only when it's pleasing to be shown. And another side of other times. Jesus, the real work of faith is what happens after we're recharged here and go out there for the rest of the week. But that was the first part. Now we're getting to the point where, well, how is it that you can recharge? How is it that you can be this way? How is it that you can do what God wants when so much of the rest of the world is saying no? When sometimes our own human nature is interested in something. Well, you can't do it alone. Because Jesus gives us the bread of life. He gives us his very self. It's very important because it's a humble expression of God. Because think of it, the Lord chooses to come to us in something that is not natural. What do I mean by that? There is such a thing called a breadfruit tree. But you can't go and pick a loaf of pumpernickel, a loaf of wheat, a loaf of white, a loaf of rye, because that's not the kind of bread it is. And yet you can grow grain, harvest it, grind it, mix it in the right proportion, and prepare bread. So it is there as God's gift, but it requires what? The work of human hands to become what it is that we expect it to be. The same thing with wine. Grapes grow everywhere, but there's no spigot flowing with wine somewhere. You have to take the grapes. You have to crush the grapes and squeeze them. You have to mix them appropriately. You have to age them, ferment them. Then you get the wine after you've done all this work of human hands. So God is so humble that he does not even assume the matter of what his creation. God assumes the matter of a creation of his creation, us, the staple of life forever, and that which lands in his hearts. And he says, we can't be without it. Because you can't fool yourself. You can't fool yourself. Notice you made reference in the gospel to those in the wilderness who ate the manna that came from heaven and died nonetheless. God has intervened many times in the history of salvation. Many times. And done many fascinating things to save people, rescue people, show people the right way. And all those people died nonetheless. Waiting for what? Waiting for Jesus as God's Savior to tell us what has to happen. So that when we go, we pass from one side of life to the next, and we enter eternal life. And that is, we must eat that living bread, which comes down from heaven. That work of the human hands that becomes something that we can't make it into. We offer it to the Lord, and the Lord turns it into his very self. Why is it that we must take advantage of that? Why is it? Well, look at human nature. Like I said, you can't fool it. If you're hungry, your body will come. If you don't eat, sooner or later,
body, you don't eat for 2 days, and you're going to drink a gallon of water. Your stomach's going to be full. After a while, you're hungry, because that's not going to do it, is it? You can't fool God. You can't fool the fool. You can't pretend to say that I'm going to live the life of a Christian and yet not partake in that which makes the Christian life possible. That which allows us to live as Jesus wants us, the gift of his very self. So today, as we continue to unfold this wonderful theme of Jesus, the bread of life, in these next weeks, we're going to be given a wonderful insight into how God thinks, and then what he puts out for us to accept for our own betterment in a life as a disciple, and also in a life as a human being. Because faith or not, God made us. And the glory of God is manfully alive. And therefore, what God tells us to do helps us to be that person who is fully alive, not just in this life, but in the life to come. Let us stay along for the ride, because there's lots of wonderful stuff coming our way. But nothing more wonderful than Jesus himself. Let us now stand and together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. For him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, which was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified on the precious blood. He suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. This kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to us. I believe in one holy and Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Mindful that we rely upon God's divine assistance, we place now our needs and petitions before the Lord.
That the Church may boldly and faithfully point to Christ as the true bread and sustenance for every human need. Of nations may work together to provide for the needs of the poor, and may know that such needs cannot be fulfilled apart from God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who teach the word of God may have grace and strength to live in their own lives the way of righteousness that Jesus teaches. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are ill, especially those who feel alone, may find in Christ and in his people the path to hope and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Wysyłaj nas, Panie.
Módlmy się za głowę.
gdzie słyszy Chrystus się, poddaje się siłę i moc dla przezwyciężenia zwątpienia. Ciebie prosimy,
zresztą
się za naszym zbawieniem, a szczególnie za zasłużonego na naszej parafii świętej pamięci doktora Michała Kulikowa, aby radowali się nad Chrystusem przybywającym w niebie. Ciebie prosimy,
zresztą
módlmy się za nas, otaczający ten ołtarz, weźmy się ofiarę, abyśmy zaufali Chrystusowi do końca. Ciebie prosimy,
zesłuchaj nas. And we wish to remember in a special way to pray for Ruthie Borgański Das from the St. Catherine's School class of 1962, who passed away this last week. Details are in the newspaper today, I hope. But for her repose of the soul and for the comfort and consolation of the family, we pray to the Lord.
Humanity over the whole world in all its wonders, to rule by your name. Jesteś Bożym i słusznie Cię sławię, święty Bożym, bo przez Jezusa Chrystusa, Twojego Syna, naszego Pana, mocą Ducha Świętego, ożywiasz i uświęcasz wszystko oraz nie ustanie gromadzić lud swój, aby na całej ziemi składał Tobie ofiarę Chrystusa. Dlatego stajemy przed Tobą zjednoczonym całym Kościołem. Uroczyście obchodzimy pierwszy dzień tygodnia, w którym Jezus Chrystus zmartwychwstał i zesłał na apostoła Ducha Świętego. Pokornie błagamy Cię, Boże, uświęć mocą Twojego Ducha te dary, który przyniesie Ci Tobie, aby się stały ciałem i krwią Twojego Syna, naszego Pana Jezusa Chrystusa, który nam nakazał spełnić to misterium. On bowiem te nocy, który był wydany, wziął chleb, dzięki Tobie składając, błogosławił, kłamał i rozdawał swoim uczniom, mówiąc: jeszcze i jeszcze z tego wszyscy. To jest bowiem ciało moje, które za Was będzie wydane. Podobnie po wieczerzy wziął kielich i dzięki Tobie składając, błogosławił i podał swoim uczniom, mówiąc: jeszcze i pijcie z niego wszyscy. To jest bowiem kielich krwi mojej, nowego i wiecznego przymierza, który za Was i za wielu będzie wylany na odpuszczenie grzechów. To czyńcie na moją pamiątkę. Oto wielka tajemnica wiary. Wybaw nas, Panie, od zła wszelkiego i obdarz nasze czasy pokoju. Wspomóż nas w swoim miłosierdziu, abyśmy zawsze wolni od grzechu i bezpieczni od wszelkiego zamętu, pełni nadziei oczekiwali przyjście naszego Zbawiciela, Jezusa Chrystusa. Twoje jest królestwo, potęga i chwała. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign.
Thank you.
show you the prayer for St. Joseph. Hail, guardian of the redeemed, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you, God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself the Father, and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us the grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from the devil. Vitae quae puniam dicet, ubique gentium maniae judis, trobia cum proviesus quae elisim, trobia zauta mani, stop Christus salus et nobile. Quotientum sepia, ocas cem versum tapse una, in potas nas nabra ducitum, viedna nam mascam, vivo sede tu parma, proina sociatum tu suam,